what permits are needed for a food truck in Oregon? And the second question was, how do I open a food truck in Portland, Oregon? This is Food Truck Freaks. We are YouTube's premier food entrepreneur channel. This is a channel dedicated to food truck industry. You can definitely check us out on our other YouTube channels, Marketing Food Online and Marketing Food Online 2, and Cottage Foods Laws, which is for home food entrepreneurs. So in this video, we're excited to bring you the licenses and permits that you're going to probably need when you start your food truck. And we're going to get into that right now. All right, so welcome back to Food Truck Freaks. If this is your first video here on Food Truck Freaks, hit that subscribe button. My name is Damian Roberti. I am a lifelong food entrepreneur. I operate over 6 e-commerce food businesses. I've had Italian pastry and bakery businesses. My wife and I have owned and operated. And I've been in the food industry for around 30 plus years. And food trucks is what this channel is all about. I love food. I am a huge foodie. And I love to bring you guys actionable information to actually get you started and up and running with your food businesses. That's why I have a ton of food channels here on YouTube, and I love to help people like you. So hit the subscribe button, give us a thumbs up, because that lets YouTube know that this video was actually helpful, and we're gonna dive right into it. Okay, so if you're looking to create a food truck business in Oregon, what permits are needed for a food truck in Oregon? That was the first question. I'm gonna go over a handful of permits and a little bit of other additional information for you. Watch all the way through to the end because we have more resources that I'm gonna actually explain to you about as well. So, number one, you're going to need, pretty much everyone needs this actually, is an EIN. It's an employer identification number. It is issued by the IRS. It actually is the tax wing of what you're going to do. So when you start hiring people, paying people, money coming in, money going out, et cetera, et cetera. Basically, the day-to-day businesses, you want to have an EIN so you can file your taxes with the IRS. And that's your number. That's basically the IRS saying, hey, this is Damian's food truck. This is his number. His EIN. Okay? Next up, obtain a business license. Now, this is, of course, just a basic, normal, common thing. You need to have a business license to operate a mobile food truck in Oregon. That's something that you're gonna need to get. And of course, the fees for business licenses are normally between about, I know ours was about $150. So you're gonna look at about $100 to maybe $200. It varies by the actual city that you're in, but they're normally not very expensive. Okay, so next up, driver's license. Of course, anyone who is driving your food truck, by the way, if you are the owner of the food truck and you have employees, be sure that at any point in time, your employee is behind the wheel, they have the proper identification with them, because you can get into serious trouble if you do get pulled over, or if you have an issue with your driving, or God forbid you actually get into an accident. Make sure everyone has licenses. But of course, the food truck owner has to have a valid driver's license in order to operate a food truck in Oregon. Seller permit. Food truck owners in some jurisdictions must apply for what's known as a seller's license, or also referred to as seller's permit, which actually allows them to buy food and other commodities at wholesale prices without paying sales tax. That's something that's overlooked in a lot of new food trucks, newbies that are to the food truck industry. You need to make sure you're not paying taxes twice. When you buy an ingredient to produce, let's just say a burrito, okay? You buy tortillas, you're buying lettuce, tomatoes, salsa, whatever it may be that you're putting in. Make sure that what you're purchasing, you're not being charged sales tax, because you are responsible for collecting sales tax when you sell the finalized product from your food truck to a customer who's gonna consume it. So keep that in mind, okay? So that seller's permit is actually really useful because it's gonna save you money, obviously, but you're not gonna get taxed twice. Next up, food handler's permit. Food handler's permit required in several states for more than one employee in the food truck. So before the permit is awarded or issued by the city or state, you may require one or more of your employees to undergo a food safety course. Now, what this means is that this is a safety training program. They're going to teach you how to handle food, keep your utensils and your equipment sanitized, cleaning items, everything about handling, serving, storing, and keeping food warm, if it must be that, or even chilled. You need to learn and understand how that works. So a food handler's permit is actually pretty common in the food truck industry and around and pretty much across the board in almost every state, actually, if in every state, you have to have some type of food handler's permit. Now, normally they could be either online or you have to go somewhere that's issued by the local city or county that you're in and take the test in order to pass that. So health department permit. So yes, food trucks and even the commissary that you're gonna use will have to have and be inspected by the health department. This is a localized thing. Your local health department's evaluation and approval will ensure that the food you prepare is kept and prepared in a safe manner, okay? Health food inspections are nothing new, and that's just a normal part of the process as well. Even in Oregon, when you're operating your food truck. Next up, a fire inspection. Most all food trucks will actually get a fire inspection. The local fire department will come in, take a look at it, make sure that everything is set up correctly, make sure that if there's any gas lines that are being used, that they are installed properly. If you're running from propane, if you're running from a generator, if you're running from a diesel generator or any other type, all of that combined needs to be inspected to ensure that it's functioning properly. Because not to sound to scare you or anything, but a food truck, in some sense, if you've got propane, you got gas, is a drivable, just something that could catch fire, and it could be done very easily. And if you're serving food, you're serving things to people at events, the fire department wants to make sure that it's done safely and nobody's going to get hurt. Okay, so this is the gist of some of the permits and licenses for Portland. Now, the other thing that you want to double check is that when you start out in Portland with your, actually in Oregon, with your food truck, it's easy to get started and actually pretty easy to operate. So Portland helps food truck operators thrive and by making licenses easy to obtain. Portland imposes no proximity limitations for food trucks. That's something that's really limiting a lot of food trucks in other cities and counties. These proximity limitations are basically saying, hey, you know what, you can't park your food truck a certain amount of footage from either a building that has a restaurant near another restaurant or a downtown area where there may be a group of people congregating, and even some business offices or corporate offices. They will limit you as to where and how close the proximity of your food truck can be to those buildings. And that can actually limit your profitability and limit your food truck business. So Portland is something that's totally different, okay? Now, vending, downtown Portland itself, if you're not just in other places or other cities, Portland has set aside a ton of parking lots dedicated to food trucks. These are areas that you can actually park your food truck, and it's specifically for your type of business. So you actually may be competing. You may be next to 5, 6, 7, or even half a dozen or more other food trucks trying to get people to buy your product. So you want to definitely keep that in mind. Now, the other thing is that Portland's food truck permits are not cheap. They're actually one of the more pricier ones across the nation when you compare them to other cities. But additional expenses are incurred by requirement that operates and obtain a special permit to cater an event. So if you're looking to do catering events with your food truck, these types of permits can be quite expensive. And you may want to figure out how to actually work that into passing that expense for that temporary mobile vending permit onto the customer, okay? So keep that in mind as well. If you're gonna be doing like events or your weddings or corporate events or anything outside, they're gonna be kind of expensive. Now, the other thing that is required is that food trucks must have a 50-gallon water tank on hand. While not every city requires this specific measure, food truck operators should create a list of what they need and include that 50-gallon water tank to ensure that they've got that on hand. That's something that Portland does require, and it's mainly for sanitation purposes and using making sure that everything stays clean, including hands and other sanitary purposes, okay? All right, so be aware, it is critical that your food truck meet all regulatory criteria. This will help you avoid any costly fines and potential closures of your food truck. Every city, county, and state does have its own set of procedures for food truck licensing and permits. So just be sure that you cross your T's and you dot your I's and you get all of the proper regulatory licenses and permits out of the way before you take a dive in the food truck business in Oregon. So that wraps up for this video. I hope this was helpful, giving you an idea and a rundown of what is really kind of needed to at least get started in the food truck industry. If you've got questions about a food truck business, Let us know down in the comments section. Also, check the description below this video. We have a ton, absolute ton of fantastic food truck resources for you to help you get started. That is why we created this channel. And we definitely appreciate the feedback and the support. If you know any friends or family who are looking to start a food truck business, share our YouTube channel with them, and we will definitely keep on posting a lot of great content. And again, like I mentioned, we have a couple of our channels that have over 1,000 videos for the food entrepreneur, including even more food truck videos. So check out our links down below to our other YouTube channels, and I will see you guys on our next Food Truck Freaks video. Thanks for watching Food Truck Freaks. If you are interested in creating your own food truck and you're trying to figure out how to do that, be sure to check out these additional resources and our website. Check out the links in the description for more information on how to create a food truck business, successful food truck business that is, and we'll see you again.